Hello people, I thought it was fun to give an update and I will try to do this weekly. So you know what quilting adventure I'm working on and you can know when you want to help or just give me feedback on what you think I'm doing. First, I want to show you this cute cat. Hello cat. It's not necessarily part of the update, but this week I've been house sitting in Haarlem. It's a town in the Netherlands, so I've had a little bit of a holiday, and it means I didn't do most of my machine quilting because I don't have a machine here. But I've been doing other kind of work, mainly working on website, networking, and stuff like that. One thing I've been working on is this. It's the turnaround coaster. Because in a few weeks, I think about 5, I'm going to do a storytelling session at a festival near the town where I live. Because I dream of storytelling and somebody gave me the opportunity. And she said she would really, and I'm going to talk about the power of vulnerability, how to live your passion, how to find the power to live life your own way. And also the Krachtteken project, where we make quilts for young people to also give them the idea and the power to live their own life. Krachttekens, we call them power blankets. And the lady organizing the festival said it would be nice if we also have an activity where people can use the knowledge I tell in my stories. And the idea is to make a mini power blanket for yourself. You can put like stones in it or a letter which is important to you because it has an opening. A friend of mine put sand stuff in it. And it holds, it can hold objects of power that give you courage and comfort. Or you can just lay it somewhere and put important objects on it for you. Like this. Yeah. So that's what I've been working on, experimenting on how to make this easier and the size of the pattern. And I think it's going to be a fun festival. Yeah, wish me luck. So that is one thing I've been working on. And also the story I want to tell. Last year, I've been storytelling a few times as well, but at some point I got scared and busy and I didn't do it anymore. So I'm very happy for this opportunity to do it again, to take my storytelling outside of YouTube and to also do it in the real world. I will keep you up to date on the updates, of course, but yeah, that's what I've been doing. And related to that, I got a bag of krachttekens for my mother, which is always fun. She is one of my volunteers who makes blankets for young people. I got like 4 for her. So that's nice because when in the summer I have an exhibition. the cat likes it. I have an exhibition for artists in Ede and I want to make it about krachttekens. So people will know about the project and I can also find partnerships with young people who would like the krachttekens. And so it's nice to have a pile of them. So when the festival happens, I have some quilts to give away. Because that's another thing I've been working on. I'm part of a business club. And in a business club, I've been working on finding partnerships with mental health hospitals or other people who work with youth. So I can find people who can give away the quilts for me. Like I dream, I picture that when there's a place where young people who are completely stuck get treatment for mental health, that there's a pile of krachttekens there. And every young person who needs one can pick one out for themselves. That's what I dream of. But those people are all overextended, people working in mental health hospitals and stuff like that. So I have to make sure that people understand what I do and understand the value I bring. So it takes a while. But that's another thing I've been working on in this project. Find people who work with the vulnerable youth. Because usually the youth are not the people who ask for a krachtteken because they don't know it exists and because they don't have the when you're down on your luck, you're not going to ask for help. So yeah, that's what I've been doing. Finding partnerships. And also another krachttekenthing I've been working on. A friend of mine who's going to be in the board of the non-profit I'm building is going to have a 10-minute presentation about krachttekens for a group of quilters in April. And hopefully that will create some partnerships of quilters who like to make quilts for others and that they maybe want to make it for me as well and the project. So lots is going on and it's all interesting, good updates. And it makes me happy to see that the work is continuing in such good fashion, because in that way society's trash will be our treasure, because the trash of the textiles that are not used anymore will become safe textiles and quilts that give courage and comfort, and also the youth who feel like trash will feel valuable again, because they get a blanket from somebody, and the people making the blanket will feel valuable as well, because sometimes quilting is not necessarily taken seriously. And I feel like when they make quilts for young people and they know that they really value it, then those people feel valuable as well, because they can do something for the young people, because that's how the world goes around. And it also reminds me, the last 2 weeks or so, 2 krachttekens were giving to young guys in this case, and they were very happy. Immediately they felt calmer, and they were, I will show one picture, the other picture I'm not allowed to share. Immediately they were happy, and they felt the energy that was in the quilt, the calming energy and stuff like that. And I also sent it to the people who made the quilt, and they were happy as well. So the project is working, and that makes me happy. So that's our the, and part of this week I was planning to work on my website, so you can learn to quilt as well through kickassquilts.org. I didn't get as far as I hoped, because I had to do work stuff as well, unfortunately. But I hope this weekend I will get some things done, and then I will update you too, and you can learn how to quilt through my website and YouTube videos. And I've been also working on flyers and other promotion materials to explain people what I do and what the value is. Like, what is the value of a krachtteken, but also what is the value of a memory quilt and turning clothes that have a memory into quilts. So I've been doing lots of different things in the hope that in the end it will lead to strong partnerships and also a way to make an income so the non-profit can have its needs met. So that's what I've been working on business-wise. Let me see my notes if I talked about everything. For now, the non-profit is going well. I have people who want to be on my board, which I'm very happy and grateful for. And now the next step is making the statues and finding a legal person to notarize it for me. So it's going very well. Hopefully by the summer it will be formalized. Yeah, so that's the official update. And now I wanted to also give you an update on what I'm working on, because it's always interesting to see. One thing I've been working on, one of my spiritual teachers wants me to work on my confidence so I can be a leader with style and energy and believe in what I'm doing. And one thing she wanted me to do is make a CV for my life. And I've been doing that by drawing all the quilts I've made. Not all of them yet, but I've started here. Because my confidence comes for a large part from the quilts I've made, especially when I was younger and I didn't know how to interact with people yet. Quilting was very important to me. For me, it was a way to feel good about myself and to feel good about the world, because no matter what happened, I could make stuff. This is a turtle quilt I made for a friend. It was also for me a way to express my feelings to my friends. And this is part of a backpack I once had. And I really enjoy it, because it ties into another love of mine of drawing and illustrating. And I will continue that, because it's nice to remember what you've made, especially when you like to give quilts away. It's nice to have a memory of what you made and how happy and proud it made me. So that's what I've been doing. Also, my house is getting a little bit tidier, which means that I have a little bit more space in my mind to work on old projects. And I've been working on finishing old projects. One of them is the Nearly Insane quilt, which I will show you later because it's at home. But another one is the Dear Jane sampler quilt, which is a very difficult quilt, and in my optimistic young years I've started it. It's the most often started quilt, least often finished quilt. It has 250, around 250 separate blocks, and it's made during the Civil War in America by Jane Stickle. I think she made it so complex because her husband and brother were at war and she wanted to distract herself. And I wanted to make it because I was thinking, if I make this quilt by hand, I know I'm a good quilter when it's finished. I finished the middle part, and now it's time to also make the border. And for a while, when I came back from Kenya, I was very confused and I didn't really know what to do with myself anymore. So I didn't have the mental focus to work on the Dear Jane, but it's back. So I'm very happy with that. And I'm picking it up again, I'm making the border, and after that it's time to quilt the hole. And it's lovely because there are many different patterns, and when it's done, I have a good sample of the wider range of quilting designs you have. And I will have the flexibility in my hands again to make complicated quilts. So yeah, things have been well lately actually. I have more confidence than I used to have, and yeah. It's nice, it helps to have the support of you, and it also helps to have the support of my job and of my lover and stuff like that. Summer helps, and it helps to make nice things. The last thing I want to show you is this. I got these from a friend, although I don't know if she knows I have them. Once we had a dream of make a quilting retreat place in an old camper in Arnhem. But it never happened because it was not a good place. But I still got some of the ideas I got there, which is these fake flowers. And I'm going to turn them into quilted flowers. I've actually done one before, but I left it in Arnhem. So I hope it gives good vibes to the person it went to. And now I'm going to turn these fake flowers with this bag of scraps into quilted flowers. And they are going to be used for a long-term goal, a dream I have of maybe stop-motion kind of storytelling with the help of quilted things and birds and stuff like that. And actually, I really like the storytelling vibe, the artist, the magician, who has like props and quilt coats and hot air balloons and little birds and moving things. I have dreams like that, and this is a small step to make them reality, and a nice way to use scraps, and a nice way also to turn society's trash into treasure, because these fake flowers are usually plastic, not very good for the environment, but they're already there. So in this way we can turn them into beautiful flowers, because flowers, cut flowers, are also not necessarily good for the environment when you import them. And in this way you have beautiful flowers in your home you can tell stories with, because you know the story of the fabrics and you know the story of creating this. And I think the little birds will like it. So that's what I've been working on. What have you been working on? Are the questions you have about my work or the plans I have for this mission of Kick-Ass Quilt? Are there other things you want to know? Do you want to know about the name, or do you want to know about quilting? Are there specific things you want to learn how to quilt? I can make a tutorial about that. Let me know in the comments. And thank you for listening. And if you want to support my work, you can check my Patreon or Ko-fi, or you can follow me or tell a friend. And for now, thank you for listening, and society's trash will be our treasure.